rained off as well. But here we go. This is Gloucestershire's first ball of the season. It's Josh Short running in to bowl it, and it's an in-swinger to the left-handed Adam Lythe, and Lythe pushes it into the covers for a single. So Yorkshire are underway straight away. Bowling now, and oh, he's bowled him! What a ball that is!
And it's full, and Lythe has got an outside edge on this, wide of the cordon, and will pick up the first boundary of the day.
Today in terms of the championship recently. That's short, that's wide, it's clattered for four by Shan Masood. That is absolutely where you cannot bowl. Here in the winter as well, Singdale bowls edged and pouched. Low down at second slip by Bancroft.
White sweatband on his left wrist. That offers a bit of room to Shan Masood, and he's taken full advantage there. Really good shot over the top of it.
Wrapped on the pads, shouting big, the finger's gone up. Root departs. This is massive.
So definitely moisture down there at pitch level. Now then, short of length, and Masood, he hasn't mastered that stroke on this occasion.
Yes, this one has been driven straight down the ground. Beautiful stroke. That fuller length.
Been lucky on the toss stakes. Short ball here from De Lange first up, and that's well controlled by Shan Masood, and nothing more really. Here's De Lange again. What has he got in response? That's a fuller length delivery and better for it. Masood has to treat that with respect.
Zaman Akhtar round the wicket bowls, over pitches, and it's driven gorgeously by Shan Masood. That's probably the shot of the morning session. Tend to find. Akhtar bowls driven and driven through the covers for four. Dismissive shot from Shan Masood.
De Lange again, short. Brook has whipped that one away around the corner, four from the moment it left the bat.
Singdale shot, dismissive from Harry Brook. Just got onto that front foot and just swatted away, and that's gone all the way. As he runs in towards us, short and wide, Brook just throws his hands at it and finds the fence again. Just in front of square on the offside, Harry Brook looks in glorious touch.
Price bowls down the pitch, comes Shan Masood. He's hit this one high up into the air, and it's one bounce just in front of the rope. He's probably thinking, I was timing the ball probably better than this last time I played on this ground. Akhtar bowls short, pulled into the gap again and for four. Through backward square leg. He tried the short ball again. Two slips and a gully. Akhtar bowls. It's another short ball. It's hit up in the air. Can the fielder get back? De Lange is getting himself underneath it, and he takes the catch. And the short ball has worked. Brook looking to pull. It goes a long way in front of square. Four slips in place. Akhtar bowls to Hill, who punches off the back foot. That's a nice looking shot, and it will get him his first boundary as a valiant pursuit from Miles Hammond, but it's an unsuccessful one.
Counting down the deliveries.
Akhtar in bowls, jabbing at that one, and he's caught behind off the last ball before lunch.
This one is shot in the air, just away from the fielder, and it will go to the fence. Skin running in, full pitch onto the pads, clipped away very, very neatly. That is the short side of the ground, and it will run away very quickly to that boundary. Second boundary of the over.
Here is Masood pushing forward to this latest delivery. 50. And it gets him through for a single that takes him to another half century. Shan Masood
runs in once again, flicked it very, very neatly, full onto the pads. And he got onto it in a flash. Shot and wide and punished. Shan rode the bounce beautifully. And those hands are so nice. Flowing drive, beautiful stroke. Shan Masood just leant into it and caressed it. Timing and placement, top class.
Zaman Akhtar from this pavilion end, who throws one up wide of off stump, and Tattersall leaning into that. He's stroked it away nicely. It's going to have the legs, yeah, just to make it to the boundary through square cover. Akhtar, wide of off stump, and again, Tattersall once more just leaning into it. He's just pushed it away, and he'll pick up four more runs. It doesn't matter whether it's power or touch.
Bit of a stroke of genius from the skipper. Shan Masood just opens that offside up for himself. Not a bad delivery at all, but it's just always new.
Yep, and he's just flicking one off his legs there. Marchant De Lange has come back on at this pavilion end and immediately conceded four. And again, just De Lange in. He's trying to york him here. It's been flicked away down the leg side for four.
Price bowls. Sweep shot. which has gone in the air and well in front of square, and it's just plugged a little as it landed, but it landed very close to the boundary.
And Tattersall this time gets the delivery wide of off stump and played it nicely there. Just touched that away, wide of second slip between there and...
It's usually pretty accurate, but potentially that might lead to him being lined up. That's short, that has been lined up, and it's gone for four. Tattersall had a go at that pull shot the previous over. They could do with him a bit cheaper than it's coming at the moment. That's short again, and that's going to be four more this time. The other side of Zaman Akhtar out on the deep square leg boundary.
Pounding in once again. It's up there, and it's run away just wide of the outstretched arm of Price at gully. And it'll bring Johnny Tattersall two runs. That takes him to a very good 50, and a much needed 50 as far as his team are concerned. A 13th first class half century to go with a couple of tons. It feels like it's getting easier to bat out there, and De Langer's over, well, not even pitched this one. It's a full toss wide of off stump. Low full toss.
Sean Masood settles in after back of a length. Not a bad delivery, but this is exquisite from Sean Masood.
Been scoring boundaries. Singdale bowls. Oh, he's bowled him. He left it.
Point a little more central. He might come into play here. Masood's got that one away a little bit straighter still. And had he not moved his man, he definitely wouldn't have got that. But he's still, although got his hand to it, knocked it into skipper against skipper. He's got it away past Dent. And Sean Masood, with a simple push through the onside, brings up his century with the single.
Tattersall after lunch.
Milne steps back then and cuts here quite nicely too. Backward of points, not quite going to have the legs to make it. Is going to have the legs to make it to the boundary. It's quite difficult actually, looking out to my right, there's reflections in the glass, and it looked as though the boundary was a bit further away than it actually was.
Short, plenty of time for Mills to swivel around and pull it square of the wicket on the onside, and that has gone all the way. Shaw full and straight, gorgeous. Sean Masood just leant on it and hit it right back where it came from.
Listening to Don Topley last week.
Van Buren is in, that's flicked to leg by Mills. Good piece of fielding there, mid-wicket. Denies.
Things go on, but they might have hoped for a bit more than that. And it's going to be more runs here for Milnes. He's going to guide a boundary down through a wide third position. Nothing that anybody's going to be able to do about that. And that
still two slips in place as they try to see the back of him. Round the wicket for Akhtar. And this could well be four more from the bat of Masood. Yep. Dive from Hammond. Coming round towards third man to field, but he can't get there. Masood again, should he wish to. Oh, beautiful shot by Sean Masood here. Round the wicket.
De Langer from the pavilion. And Sean Masood, his fingers have gone up. Sean Masood had already started to walk.
They're not taking their chances on top of having those periods.
This one is nicked and gone. Fuller delivery.
As Ed was saying last year at Sussex, and that's one of his favoured shots, but on this occasion he's hit it straight to mid-off and has gone.
He runs away from us. Slow delivery. He got hold of that, all right. Fisher. That is a massive six.
His actor again, short. Now then, he's got underneath this one and should be caught by Bracey. He is. That is the end of Matthew Fisher for 20 and the end of Yorkshire.
Code round the wicket to bowl to Dent, his first ball of the season, and it's going to be his first runs. And it's trickling down towards the fine leg boundary, and it will make it for four. It's also a no ball, so that will be six runs onto the total. Three slips and a leg slip. Fisher bowls to Dent, who defends into the ground, and it's trickling back towards the stumps, and it's gone into the stumps, and the bail has come.
Codd's next delivery knocked him over. The front foot defensive shot wasn't good enough.
Still got three deliveries left to face tonight, though. Here's the first of them, and this is nudged by Shaw, and that will go down for just the inning's second boundary, down to the vacant third area. Milnes runs in and bowls a bumper. It's down the leg side. It's just past the diving Tattersall, between the keeper.
Just slightly out of his reach.
Last ball of the day. Milnes bowls to Shaw. Inside edged into the leg side for some reason. They don't take a single. It doesn't matter. So he's happy enough to do it. But as you say, at some point, surely he will want to get the board moving. That's edged by Sean Courts in the cordon. Milnes bowls full, inviting the drive. That's about the first delivery which really was asking to be put away. And that is the first boundary of the morning, nearly 40 minutes in. Got to get him back in sooner, but maybe you're grateful. This is pulled away by Hammond and pull away for four. Fisher in, bowls, Hammond drives. That's a good looking shot. Beats the sprawl of Fisher in his follow through. Long chase for Shan Masood down towards the straight long off boundary. Fisher continues what looks like it's going to be the short pitch barrage, and Hammond hoiks this one high up into the air. Fielder at deep backward square, but he's gone over the boundary.
For their efforts.
This is down the leg side from Code, flicked away towards long leg, and that is 50 for Cameron Bancroft. He's had to grind, he's had to battle, but he's made it. Code in, shorter ball, Hammond helps it round the corner, and there is no fine leg, so that will go for four.
Right up there, and I think that's why we'll probably try see him try to, as Bancroft tickles one round the corner, down to 45 where there is no man. Adam Lythe makes a chase down to the rope, but looks like the ball might just get there, and it does. That's four runs to Bancroft.
Just for that little flick on the rise, we saw, I think, just one of those from Cameron Bancroft this morning, but we've got a wicket here.
Moriarty again. This time a firm push drive down the ground, and it went past Moriarty. Two fielders are on a drive now for the left-handed Bracey.
It's short though, and there's only one fielder back on the leg side, and Bracey's pumped the pull shot away for four through backward square leg, and that.
But Moriarty's bowling over the wicket. This one was in the air. Did it carry? I'm not quite sure.
I thought it did, I must say.
And it's gone all the way, just to the opposite side of the ground in front of the side screen. Four runs. Moriarty and Bancroft, the battle resumes. Goes down the wicket. It's in the air. And taken! That one mistake that they wanted from Bancroft. He got tempted. This was a slightly flighty delivery. Left-hander, this one is in the air. Slightly flighter. And allowed Bracey to get down. It's Charlesworth, rather. And that languid swing, and it's gone all the way. Moriarty again. The flighty delivery. Firm drive. The mid-off was in. And it just went past him. No chance for the fielder at long on.
The footholds. Root bowls. Driven by Bracey. That's a gorgeous stroke. And that will have enough on it to go to the boundary. Pursuit will be in vain. And a really pleasant drive from Bracey. Lengths that Yorkshire are bowling. That's too short from Root. That's really the first genuine bad ball that he's bowled, actually, in his nearly nine overs. And Bracey cuts it to the rope. We can prolong things by sticking those on. Root bowls, Bracey drives again, slightly uppishly, but again he's timed it well enough to go for four off the bat. I thought he'd kind of chipped that one, but it flew away.
It's going to be one over after the tea break before it can be taken now. Oh, chance gone! Adam Lythe has done it again. Golden arm Lythe has got the wicket there of James Bracey. A big, big wicket, 39 and gone, caught at slip, well caught at slip as well. That will be the tea break as a result.
And a leg slip as Code bowls to Charlesworth. It's on his pads, and that is a loosener, and that might go for four through forward square leg, and it will do. So not the start that Code
Fisher can come up with. That was short and wide, asking for trouble, and punished by Charlesworth. He's been in that kind of mood. Nothing that he could spare. This was loose, though, you have to admit.
Code in bowls, and Van Buren has played an extraordinary shot and got out to it. He's nicked off behind.
Talanga has had a swing at it, and it's gone all the way. He got hold of that all right. Caught in the crowd. Fisher again. Talanga has a swing, and it went over the top of the slip cordon. That's exciting stuff.
Hartley driven straight back down the ground by De Lange, and although not as spectacular as the six he hit, here he is again, and De Lange steps away to leg, and he's going to get four more here through the covers. So on a day when scoring runs has been Fisher again, should be out, is out. Caught there by Milnes again, stepping away to the leg side.
He's just coming to plug that gap between long off and deep point as Charles Woods gives the charge and hits it over the head of Sean Masood. He goes over the top. That sounded really, really sweet. Over to you.
Oh, good delivery from Fisher. Big appeal gone. End of the innings. Who knows whether we'll be back on.
Is Josh Shaw bowling the first ball to Lythe, and that's a gorgeous shot. First ball. Delicious timing through the covers for four runs. And
none of these batters in red ball cricket like to bat under lights.
Shaw bowls. It's pretty prodigious in-swinger, but it's going to be four more runs. Shaw afford this to be getting away from them quickly, and it just might be short, wide, and cut away for four. And you can hear that there are plenty of travelling Yorkshire fans as well. Shaw starts his second over, bowling full to Lythe, who plays a delightful on drive, whistling across the outfield.
Anywhere around that general area, he steps away here and he will get off the mark with a lovely shot. Van Buren giving him the office to open his shoulders there, short of length, and he's stepped back and he's cracked that away straight out of the middle of the bat.
Golf balls on his shins.
Now he steps back again and he's got this one straight through the covers this time. Van Buren, that's a poor delivery, having strayed the ball before.
Three slips now as that short and wide cut away by Adam Lythe to the boundary. And you can't afford to present Adam Lythe with that sort of scoring opportunity.
That went aerial behind square, slightly short off the back foot. Ian will collect a boundary.
This one possibly among the best of them. This is Adam Lythe playing his trademark, almost Caribbean style, foot off the floor. Singdale bowls to Lythe, who drives, gets a full on half volley, and that has been spanked for four.
The final over of today, up and over is Adam Lythe, and that is a boundary. Well worth the wait. Final delivery of the day, and this is outside the off stump. Bean will let it go.
As Joshua comes into bowl, it's up there to drive, sure. And the invitation accepted. Finlay Bean down the ground with a beautiful straight drive.
In plenty of time. Singdale in bowls, full driven by Lythe. That's a great way to bring up his first boundary.
Shaw turns and leaves our commentary position behind. And the ball angled in towards Bean, who's pulled it for four. Lovely shot by Finlay Bean, rocking onto the back foot. It was telegraphed, he banged it in.
In goes Singdale, bowls over the wicket. This is clipped by Bean, very fine. There is that.
Here's Shaw again, and Adam Lythe just punches that one out to point. And the single will bring him to 50 in first-class cricket for the 70th time.
Was that all?
To go with 33. Short. Ooh, Finlay Bean tries to play the pull shot, but he got that one wrong, and he's managed to top edge it.
It's again driven on the up, beautifully timed, and that will run away to the boundary. That is probably the shot of the morning from Adam Lythe.
No, in fact, no, Singdale is there, so somebody else has gone off.
Another beautiful drive, same result, Zafar Gohar diving, but it was out of his reach. Beautiful timing, just lent into it.
Open to you anymore. Actor bowls, this is full and driven away for four more by Finlay Bean. Not perhaps quite as well timed as the two drives in the previous over from Adam Lythe, but still more than good enough. Actor bowls, this is driven in the air, but it's in the gap between extra cover and mid-off. For a moment it looked as if it might have been heading straight into the hands of Charlesworth.
I think it should be in favour of the batter. This one has been pulled top edge though. And it has gone all the way. Delanga's next delivery is full, and crashing it through the covers is Adam Lythe. This is a magnificent stroke. Great sight. Left-hander hitting a cover drive. Delanga's full toss attempted Yorker has been timed away. Pulls to Lythe this time, short. Zafar Gohar has been kept busy this time. Once again, the dive was in vain. Third boundary, the hat-trick of boundaries from Adam Lythe, this time off the back foot. Right in the middle of that gap as we watch Price. A full toss, almost a freebie. Bean would think that he'll get a boundary, and he does. opposing. They will just literally run into the field as this one has been swept towards that short boundary, and it will go away for a boundary. Adam Lyth continues.
Price bowls again, little short, well, more than a little short, in fact, very short, and cut away powerfully through extra cover and away to the long boundary for four runs.
He comes pounding in again. Oh, there we go, he has done this time. But it was down the leg side, flicked off the legs by Bean, and just has too many legs for Ajit Singh Dale. So four runs to Finlay Bean, 65 to him now. So DeLanger turns again, comes pounding in, past umpire Peter Hartley. Lyth has one to drive at, pushes it into the gap in the offside. It might have the legs for four. Actor is going to reel it in, but they get back for two, and Adam Lyth punches the air yet again. 101 on the board, centuries in successive Division 2 County Championship matches at the start of this season. One, I think it was, as Bean flicks one round the corner here, just straying a little bit there. Ollie Price to leg stump.
As he's in again, and there's turn there, and he's been given LBW. I know there's going to be a big total on the board for them to either chase or time to survive, as this is driven forcefully through extra cover. Here's Singh Dale bowling, and this is again guided away and misfielded by Bancroft, and that's going to cost four runs.
Bat Gloucestershire out of the game. His reverse sweep comes out, and it goes straight to short third, and Adam Lyth cannot believe what he's done. Slip in for Joe Root, short cover, short mid-wicket catching, slightly short, lays back, gloriously played by Joe Root, behind square on the offside for a boundary. Always seems to happen as we watch Van Buren next delivery. Sean Masood has clattered it over deep mid-wicket fence. It's a short boundary, but it went way over.
To bowl here to Joe Root, who tries his reverse paddle sweep, and he's got it away nicely, and that will be four, scattering the pigeons down there who were fielding just inside the boundary row, but they don't fancy it that much.
You got to play with a certain ball. It's our home series, as Sean has really played it beautifully down the ground, offering the full face of the bat.
The travel in Yorkshire support are in pretty good spirits. A couple of yards to his right as Root tries to play this one aerially. The sweep, has he got it away all the way? He has. That is very well picked up by Joe Root.
Using his feet here is Shamasud, and he's stumped down the leg side.
You just curled your nose up, so maybe you've got something different to offer us as Root pushes into the offside. Wants one, checks on that because he thought it was going to be fielded, and then has got through for another one. And the applause will tell you that Joe Root has yet another first-class half-century to his name.
And really hit it hard. In that.
Oh, fodder here. Oh, dear me. Graham Van Buren has dragged that one down, and Harry Brook has dragged that one up. Yeah. Actor is in to Root, who's flicking it one down the leg side, and he's gone. Zaman Actor has the wicket of Joe Root.
A very good pre-season tour.
Van Buren is in, and Brook pushes away through point. They put everyone back on the offside, and Brook calmly moves to another half century. This one has come from 43 deliveries, that is all, and yet...
Exactly, as Hill has got hold of that. Just moving away from his stumps and hitting it towards car corner.
Price is in short again. Pulled high in the air. Van Buren's underneath it and takes the catch. Right on the boundary, but he knew exactly where the boundary was. Short runs in, bowls, and there's a left leg out the way and a heave. Handsome shot down the ground from Milnes, soaring away for six. And that might have gone over the top of the stand into Legends Walkway.
Quite open. It's short. Not wide enough, but just give him enough time to punch it off the back foot. They were captaining. They couldn't get to the playoffs.
Code in. Oh, wicket. He's flicked it off his legs, Chris Dent. And Finlay Bean has taken a very good catch with the ball just down by his feet.
And catch him in a surprise. And
code in again. Cracked away this time. Just a little bit too short. Here he comes again. It's full, driven down the ground. This is going to be four more. A flailing dive from Moriarty, and the ball has just bobbled over the rope by a couple of feet. Sweatband on his left wrist, and he's going to go for four runs here. just too much width on this occasion. Tattersall standing up. In past umpire Adnan. Nicely played. Nicely played, Ollie Price. Just got had to climb high tiptoes. This is by coming back out for four overs. Short ball here from Milnes. And again, Price just arching his back slightly to get into the right position.
Like pylon will make its way more towards the pitch as it goes on. Silly Point moves to short leg as this is played to mid-wicket to end the over. And then stands in good stead.
There's Nick, they're appealing and the finger's gone up. Big wicket there. That funny run up there from Mills.
Side first delivery. Here comes Moriarty again, and this is slapped unceremoniously over the bowler's head for six. Done in terms of their annual allowance. Moriarty bowls. Hammond drives over the top of Shan Masood at mid-off. He's got plenty of that, and it goes away for four.
Short extra cover catching, and it Shot. Has beaten that. There was not much of a gap there. Shan Masood will chase in vain. Classical off-drive. This is short and no protection on the offside. Easy pickings on that occasion. This was an error from Root, and Hammond, one of the fielder from the ring of the offside, has been sent to the sweeper as this one is edged. This was the area probably Root was looking to bowl throughout the over. Perfect line, perfect length. Credit in the first innings that anyone from this lineup, as next one has been clipped very, very fine by Price. Action-packed over. And this time, Price will collect a boundary.
Moriarty is in. And, oh, gone. There's your third wicket, Howard. 88, caught by 88. Hammond by Brook.
Fisher in, bowls full, and strikes Shaw on the pad. Got to be out, is. Hassan Adnan raises the finger. Yorkshire get the night watchman. And now the question is, are Gloucestershire going to send another night watchman in? Shaw looks to the heavens, but you could see he was expecting the short ball.
Moriarty in for the final time of the day then. Ooh, it is the former, but it wasn't so far off being the latter. Here's Code, driven, nicely driven as well by Bracey. That's four runs. Masood diving for it at short mid-off.
Moriarty is in, driven by Bracey. Nice looking shot through the offside, and although the outfield is noticeably slower than it has been at...
Be used to seeing him do so, but it's going to be the left arm of Moriarty in again, and just been picked off backward of square. In fact, that's going to have the legs to go all the way for four. George Hill giving vain chase.
But that's just about it that I can recall off in the 45 minutes as Root starts another over. Slower on that occasion, but wide off the off stump. And Price will pick up a couple of runs towards back foot point. And that will bring up his 50 as well. Round the wicket now to left-handed Bracey, who's jumped on a long hop and timed it very nicely.
It was dying on Adam Lythe. Unfortunate. Moriarty's in. Bracey turns that round the corner. He's already had four down there today. Root's giving chase, but won't be able to stop it. And it's four more to Bracey.
Morning, Faisal. As Root continues, and this is cut away powerfully through extra cover in for four by Price. Joe Root watching as... except a sort of reverse version. This is short, pulled away by Bracey dismissively and to the boundary.
Fisher starts off fresh over. Short again. Field was set, but it eluded that leg gully and, as it were, round the wicket. Again, taken on by Price finds another boundary.
Short straight mid-wicket, and Bracey drives. Moriarty can't field it off his own bowling, and there's nobody anywhere near that, although again the ball is threatening to hold up, but it will just...
And he's bowled another short one, and it's been pulled for four backward of square leg. Strong wind that did a couple of laps just before he came back on after lunch. Fisher is in, short, pulled with more control this time, and pulled for four again. Here he is, short. He's going to go for four more here. There's no bounce about that one down the leg side. He's really annoyed with himself, but he's been pulled.
Moriarty bowls short. Bracey pulls that away and will pick up four more runs. That brings up his half century. 52 to his name from 99 deliveries. He's been severe on anything short. The field has been up.
At this pavilion end again, bowling here to the right-handed Ollie Price. Short, first up again. And pulled around the corner, and four more. So he can't get this short ball right. He's striving to do so. Catching George Hill as well at short mid-off. And therefore, this short delivery from Fisher, which has been cut by Bracey. Here he comes again, and that's a short ball. Milnes pulled by Price. Has it got the legs? Yes is the answer to that.
Fuller delivery in the air, went past that fielder at short mid-off. Bracey will collect a boundary.
Moriarty is in again. He steps back and cuts, and that will be a fourth first-class century for Ollie Price, who has deserved it. Played really well. He's pulled particularly well in this afternoon session because he was fed a number of deliveries to do so earlier on.
Milnes runs away from us. Fuller delivery in the air, but few fielders in that direction as the dive from Hill, is it? Was not enough to save. Shan Masood trying to save the boundary.
Batters who probably would have pulled out there. Lithe bowls short and punched off the back foot through extra cover. That is a gorgeous shot from Ollie Price.
This time it's again short. No protection there. Just the two fielders on the onside. And it will go away to that fence very, very quickly. But looks like it didn't happen for them as Moriarty starts off with another flatter delivery. Pushed onto the onside, plenty of big gaps, and a short boundary will help Bracey pick up yet another boundary. Drop, if you just throw it up in...
Lithe bowl, short, pulled away, hammered through mid-wicket for four by Price. And that is going to get the treatment, especially with the confidence of that short boundary to target.
Cover sweeper, mid-off, mid-on, straight mid-wicket, and a 45 behind square leg side. Short of length, first up from Root, is Loosener, and he's been dispatched.
Counter-argument to that being is Moriarty bowls to Price, who drives but won't pierce the gap on the offside, being that, you know, last night there had been more time, that have had Bracey out there as well. One more wicket, who knows? You know, you really do start to get lower down in the batting order. Being in the field, Moriarty bowls swept again by Price round the corner, and that's heading towards the fine leg boundary as well. Unless it just stops, it does not. That brings...
We all knew.
But yes, it went to safety. As another paddle round the corner is executed by Price, and that's running towards the boundary. It's spinning away and it goes over the rope. 283 for four. Moriarty bowls short, cut by Price, and he's found the gap on the offside, and there's a chase on, but it's not a successful one as Fisher sprawls over the rope and the ball eludes him. Perhaps this one will, though. Code in, bowls, beats the edge of Price. Has it taken it? It has. Price has gone and he's out.
Can he get a second wicket in this spell? Not with this delivery, and that could be it for James Bracey. Will be it for James Bracey. Turns it away down to fine leg. Pumps his fist in the air, holds his bat high above his head, and it is a 10th first-class century. Code into Bracey again. He's got him. The very next ball, Bracey edges it through. That's a very good catch by Johnny Tattersall.
For the most part, an exciting conclusion, although, of course, we have lost eight overs from today. This is wide outside the off stump from Hill and crashed off the back foot by Charlesworth through the covers, and that will go to the boundary. Still important. Probably put paid to many extra overs. Moriarty in, driven by Charlesworth. He gets a wide half volley that he goes after and puts it away through the covers for four.
Johnny Bairstow. Short, and Van Buren has given it a fearful thump. Slip in a gully in place. But that length is too short and won't trouble Charlesworth at all. Shan Masood is hot in pursuit, but it will be in vain. As the ball goes into the cover boundary.
We're back to, as Moriarty bowls to Charlesworth, who works that one confidently off the back foot through the leg side. That will have more than enough legs on it to go to the mid-wicket boundary for four runs. Very nicely played by Charlesworth, a powerful...
Catching in close, Charlesworth gives the charge, not convincingly, of a thick inside edge. We'll still find a boundary towards deep mid-wicket. Root again, when Buren goes... onto that back foot and cracks it towards square leg boundary for a boundary. And that is probably Van Buren's most emphatic stroke in this inning so far.
need to vet those.
Van Buren repeats the dose that he did earlier in the over. Umpire Hassan Adnan showing us some nifty bit of footwork as he avoids that hit from Van Buren. get the batters out onto their front foot. I mean, they had plenty of runs to play with. As Van Buren goes for a sweep, gets a thick inside edge, went past the leg slip, and will have enough legs to go over the...
Shaw pulled by Van Buren, who's going to get four more here. 36 to him now.
They're 103 for two after 9.4. They need 106 more.
Fisher... Fisher? Where did that come from? Moriarty. That's just dragged one down. 386 for six. Moriarty in, stepping back. Van Buren again. Tracks it away. Pretty similar to the ball before.
Not exactly given to them, but definitely down to the batters going after it. Adam Lythe is bowling from the Ashley Down Road end, and he's been whipped away. Moved down the order so far has brought a couple of really good innings from him.
Oh, now then, edge this time from Charles with two in an over, one from each batter.
What is the last over, and then you've got to take four wickets in it. Lythe bowls short, cracked away on the pull shot by Van Buren. He sends it through backwards square leg for four, and that is a 50 for the Gloucestershire skipper.
Sheer bloody mindedness.
Yes, I think it is, isn't it?
We've been here all day. We're going to make his day for an extra
one. This out to the bitter end. This is pushed out into the covers for no run.